Hello again. Welcome back to the card mat. Now this is a very nice trick. It's a mentalist trick, and it's as if you're reading two people's minds at once. You start off with a deck of cards and you can spread them out to show them that the cards are all completely mixed up. There's no set order to them. Then you see you're going to cut the pack into half and give one half to one spectator and one half to the second spectator. See to the first spectator to either look through the packet and choose whichever card they want, or take it out blind, so that they, whatever. You get them to pick a card at any rate. So we just spread the pack out and say they take that one there, right? So the first spectator has picked that card. You do the exact same thing with the second spectator and ask them to pick whichever card that they want. Say they pick that one. Right, now I'm going to have to turn around now while I show you the cards. Spectator 1, Spectator 2. So I've turned around, I'm not looking at the camera or anything, so I can't see exactly what's going on. And hopefully you can see Spectator 1's card and Spectator 2's card. Right, I'm turning them back down and I'm turning back around. Right, so Spectator 1 then sticks his card anywhere into Spectator 2's packet. And Spectator 2 puts his card anywhere into Spectator 1's packet. And then they can give the pack a shuffle to make sure that I don't know where the card is and they don't know where the card is. And I think that'll do on that. And you get this one shuffled. Completely messed up. So the cards are all over the place. One last go. Right. Now you say to Spectator 1, just to think of their card mentally. Think of their card, think of the picture, visualize the picture and try and project the picture to yourself while you look through the pack and try and pick up on their vibes to try and find their card. And you got to think harder than that. You have. I'll go for that one there. I'd say that was your card. Then you do the exact same thing with Spectator 2. Ask them to think of and mentally project an image of that card to you while you look through this pack to try and find their card. Again, this fella's got better projection skills because I think it's that one. Just have a look at the other ones. Yeah, I'd say second spectator had that card. For the first time, you can ask spectators one, which card did they actually pick? They'll name it and you'll turn it. Hopefully it was right. You do the same thing with Spectator 2. They name it, you turn it. Well, hopefully they were right. I'll find out in the rerun. But as I say, pretty nice nifty trick. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll tell you, I won't bother with nothing else. I'll just go straight into the tutorial, which is very easy. All you do is split the deck. All the even cards and all the odd cards. Or you can do it with, say, all the spades and all the hearts and all the clubs and all the diamonds, but that looks a bit more suspicious. Then what I've done to make sure that I actually cut the pack in half is I've put a crimp on what's going to be the bottom card of the top packet. So as you can see, I've just got that card and I've just put a little bend in the corner, stick it on, and when you put it onto there, I'll square them up so you can try and see properly. You can see that there's just a little gap there now. So if I cut at that gap, picking that one up with it, I've cut right down. So I've got all the odds up here and all the evens down there. So as I say, you can start off, you can show all the cards that they're completely random. Try not to leave them too much on show because some smarty pantsers might notice that it's odds and evens. And you turn it over, then using that little break, you just pull it down with your little pinky and you cut the pack in half. So I've cut it right into half. Well, the rest's straightforward. You probably guessed what happens. They pick any card you want to out of there. So they're obviously picking an odd card since these are all the odds. And you get them to pick any card you want to out of this one. So they're picking an even card. Then you get the odd card put into the even pile, and you get the even card put into the odd pile, and get them shuffled up. And you get this one shuffled up. That's all straightforward now, isn't it? All you do then is tell them to think of their card, and you just go through this pack of the odd cards, and all you're doing is looking for an even one. And don't forget, the queens are even, your jacks and your kings are odd. So you can find it straight away. That's the only even card, and you put that face down on the table. I didn't show you what to wear, but then again, it doesn't matter, does it? Now you're just looking for an odd card in here. And there we go, the only odd card in that pile. Then you just get them to name them, and you turn them, and you're done it. And how was that for a nice quick one? But you've never seen a tutorial that quick off me before. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a bit of practice. Doesn't take any kind of practice, really. You just separate the cards into odds and evens. Put a little crimp in the middle card, and you're good to go. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you again soon.